Hello, my name's Fred McNeil, and you're watching QAC TV7. We have a great show, and it's called Commissioner's Corner. Now, all of our newly elected Commissioner's Corners made a very big point out of when they're running for office, we want to communicate with the public. And one of the things they've asked for and demanded, quite frankly, is a chance where they can come on Channel 7 and talk about current issues that affect you, affect the county, and of course, affect them as people governing our county. We're delighted to have with us from the 3rd District, County Commissioner Robert Buckey. Robert, thank you for coming today.
Fred. Okay. Great to be here.
And there's some signs of spring. There's hope.
Oh, yeah.
Now, Robert and I have a lot of things in common, but our favorite to our love of Queen Anne's County, and we're Redskins fans.
Yes, we are.
There's hope for spring, but not for the Redskins, right?
No, unless we can get that quarterback at the fifth, unless he drops to the fifth, I don't think we have a shot.
It's going to be a long season again.
It is.
Robert, let's start off with one of the things you promised during the campaign. I'm going to go out and talk to the people.
Sure.
I'm going to tell them what I'm doing. You had a great town hall meeting. I'd like to share with the folks. You had 60 people, almost 70 people show up. You had over 40 emails with questions. So how about tell the public about that town hall meeting, where it was, how it happened, and what you got out of it?
Sure, no problem. I decided, during the campaign, mm-hmm. I really feel that the people should be involved in governing sure. conversations. At least their voice should be brought to the table. And that's one thing I'm going to do for the next 4 years is make sure citizens
Good.
Are
yeah.
heard. Wheatlands was a hot subject. What the county commissioners did on December the 9th, we came in and rescinded the prior commission's 11th hour move on granting the waiver for the Wheatlands.
I
felt that it wasn't a good deal for Queen Anne's County personally, and I felt that we needed to step in and make it a better deal for the county because anything could have been put up there.
Sure.
And that corner affects the Baltimore Washington D.C. corner. It's a busy area, and if
sure.
we don't get it right, it's going to be horrible for Queen Anne's County residents.
Now, was that the hot topic?
Yes.
So the
meeting was all about the Wheatlands. For
okay.
me to understand what's going on with the sure. community. It was a great turnout. It was 68 people. I had 42 emails.
Now, where was it?
It was at the Graysonville Senior Center.
Okay, so that's a packed house, right? That's
it was packed.
House,
it
yeah.
was packed. I had 4 county employees there. A gentleman from George, I think his name, mm-hmm. from here.
George Harvick, yeah.
George, Steve Cahoon, Todd Mann, and one other individual
okay.
just kind of helping out.
Sure.
The atmosphere was fantastic. People expressed their opinions. I want to say out of the 68 that were there, probably 55 spoke.
Actually asked you questions
yes.
and presented a viewpoint. Good.
Their viewpoint.
So you listen.
Of course.
A lot of listening
going
on.
Of course. And, yeah. I took away from that what I think the citizens deserve and what they want. So it went fantastic.
Good. Good.
And I look to have these at least 4 times a year. So
you plan, and the good thing is you put it on the website.
Mm-hmm.
On Channel 7, we'll announce when there are.
Good.
And you encourage the people come there with their questions. And
correct.
Sounds like to me you did a lot of listening.
Oh, that's what this is about.
Good.
And I don't think people want to hear me talk.
Sure.
They want it. They want someone that's going to listen to them. And that's what I did.
Well, good for you for doing that.
Thanks.
You kept the promise right. Now, obviously, 70 people. What was the temperature that night?
10 degrees. 10
yeah.
degrees below. It was the coldest night. It was coldest
sure.
night on record.
So if you had that many people, you're in big trouble in the
right,
spring.
Right.
You're in a pack.
I'm okay. I'm okay. And you know what? And I want it tough. I don't want to come across. I don't want anything easy,
sure.
because, I'm county commissioner, and one of the things that we do affects everyone here, including myself,
sure,
for the
does.
future. So it's very important.
So you
to
want to hear from the people.
Of course.
You're not afraid to hear from them.
I'm not afraid.
Okay.
I'm not going to go into a shell. If it's a tough topic, if I don't agree with you, I'm up front. I'm going to tell you I don't agree with that.
Okay.
And it is what it is. We can move on and fight another fight. So
and you listen to opposing views, and then you're going to work out the right decision.
Correct.
Okay. Robert, a couple of things we wanted to talk about. We want to ask you, why did you vote for the engineering sewer project?
Sure.
Everyone's talking about that project. Why don't you share where you are on that?
No, great. As you know, I ran against the Ken Allen sewer project.
Right.
I'm still opposed to the Ken Allen okay. sewer project. I believe this sewer study will really give us all the answers we're looking for. The actual cost. What's it going to, what is it going to take to really get this system down there?
Right.
So this is that next step. It's like kind of being a juror. How can you come up with a decision unless you get all the facts, right? So to me, this was one of the facts that I'm going to use.
Get this study and I can sit down and look at it.
Exactly. This study is going to tell us, from what I understand, whether this sewer is going to be $50 million or $100 million.
Okay.
And then I can also use this study to use my platform, what they call the cluster system, is what I still believe belongs
okay.
down there.
That's what you want.
That's what I want. That's what I believe. I still believe that the system is too expensive. I still believe there's a lot of people that are citizens in this county that can't afford to pay that. They're retired. That's not a that area is not.
You have a lot of middle class people who are retired.
You have a lot, yes.
And they're on fixed income.
Yes,
right?
That's exactly
right.
My point.
You want to protect them.
I do. I truly do. You know, so that's why I voted for that. I can tell you now, and I'll say this now, and it's probably bad to do because I'm not a real politician.
That's okay.
I would never vote for the sewer unless there were some real hard facts over the next couple of years that there's some. I don't want to see health concerns either. Yeah. You know, look, I don't want to pass. I don't want to sit there and say, oh, Commissioner Buckey, you know, you didn't vote for the sewer, so it didn't go through, and now my son is sick with cholera. You know, I don't want that.
No, you look at the health facts, you look
at
all the facts. That's why you asked for the study, correct?
Thank you. That's exactly
right. Okay, and that's the right thing to do.
Thank you.
Now, you talked about at your open meeting that the Wheatlands project, was a big issue. So where are you? Why did you vote against that? I mean, you want to just clear that
up?
Sure.
Okay, well, I voted against it, as I said, Fred, is that I feel that Queen Anne's County citizens deserve to know what's going on and what's going to happen there at that intersection. That's going to be, as you know.
And the intersection, everyone knows, we're talking with the outlets area right in there.
Well, as you know, the prime outlets are here, and this is Route 50, right? And this is 301. There's a turning lane right here.
Right.
And in the summertime, in spring, this turning lane gets packed.
That's a dangerous turning lane.
And then
lane.
It's backed up all the way to the Kent Narrows Bridge. Right. And Kent Island residents, myself and other people trying to move around Queen Anne's County, they can't get through.
You're not happy.
When you put the Wheatlands across the street, and if we don't design this right, or at least have the county have some sort of an input, we're going to make the problem worse. But I can tell you this, the Waterman family are fantastic. I think they care about Queen Anne's
County. They're working with you.
They are working with us. And if this project was turned over to a company in California, they wouldn't care rat's butt what went there.
Okay.
But the Waterman family does.
They care because they're locals. They
correct.
Go to church here. They shop here. And they're part of the community.
And I think they have a fantastic plan that they're going to present that I think the community is going to love.
Okay. So that's where you're on that.
Yeah, I can say that. I don't want to go anymore because
it's still a live issue.
It's still a live issue. It's in litigation still, although we do have a 60-day stay from the attorney, so I can speak about it. But I can tell you that I'm hoping very soon we're going to bring this back to the county commissioners.
Good.
And we're going to have a great plan that the community is going to like.
And all five commissioners are studying
yes, sir.
And looking into
it. And this is why I did what I did.
Good.
This is why I voted to do that, because if I hadn't have, we could have ended up with stuff there that would have affected this county for 50
forever,
years.
Forever. Okay.
Exactly. So that's why I did what I did.
Okay, good. Thanks for clearing that
You're
up.
Welcome.
Now let's talk about, you wanted to make sure we talked about some things you campaigned on and where you're on them now. One of the things you talked about was pay raises during the campaign. Where are you?
Thanks
what,
for,
what pay raises are we talking about?
Okay, well, as you know, I ran against the idea of the commissioners voting to give themselves a 30% pay increase from the $19,000 to the $25,000 where it is today. Guys, I get the fact. You know, I work 80 hours a week just as a county
it's
commissioner.
It's not a part-time job, is it?
No. I've been into my office, my pest control company. I'm sorry. My pest control company two times since the day I put my hand up in the air. Two times. It's literally suffering because this job takes a lot out of you.
Sure.
If you want to be a good commissioner,
it's a full-time job.
It's two full-time jobs. I mean, literally, I'm doing day and night stuff for the county, and I really enjoy this. And I'm not doing it for the recognition. When I meet people, they go, oh, Commissioner, don't call me Commissioner. I'm Bucky.
You're approachable.
I'm doing this, as I always said, I want to make Queen Anne's County the best county in the state of Maryland. It deserves to be. We have the best people in this county. Yeah, there's some nutcases here. I get that. Okay. But there's also 99.9% of the greatest people in the state.
They want to do the right thing.
Exactly. And we have the best workers in the state of Maryland that a county can offer, in my personal opinion. So
right now, do you stand, you're not in favor of the pay raise?
I'm not in favor of the pay raise. So anyways, make a long story short, 2 months ago, I brought up a motion, and I'm bringing back a motion. As soon as Pat Thompson finishes the wording on it, I am requesting that the next pay raise that the commissioners receive will be voted on with a referendum to the citizens.
Oh, the people will vote on the pay
raise. The people will decide whether or not the county commissioners deserve a 30%, 50%, 100%. I don't care, but let's leave it up to the people. It's their money. It's not my money. Or it's not my money to sit there and say, Fred, if you run again in 4 years, I'm going to vote to give. See, I can't vote to give myself a raise.
No, it's the next group that comes in.
I don't think that's fair to do, especially if I'm running for county commissioner. I benefit from that.
Okay.
So
good.
That's why I'm bringing back a motion. And
let the public decide if you get a pay raise.
Let's let the public decide.
Good. All right. That's a good choice. No one can complain about that.
Let them decide. If they think that the county commissioners deserve it, didn't give it to them.
Okay, good. Okay. Weekly, big issue during the campaign was weekly meetings. Should the commissioners meet weekly or monthly or whatever? Where do you stand on that?
Absolutely, we should work weekly. This county is a $120 million a year business. You name me or have one of these citizens tell me a company that has $120 million a year that meets twice a month, and I'll resign tomorrow.
Okay.
And I'll resign. They don't.
It goes back to the hours weekly. You're putting in. It's a full-time job.
Well, of course,
right?
It does. Yeah. But the commissioners themselves need to be out front of this. I think that we need to, my personal opinion, the reason why I want to meet once a week, and it's really not once a week, and I'll kind of go over my schedule if I can. Our meetings are marathons.
It's all day, right?
And a lot of things get kicked off because a commissioner has to go here, or a commissioner has to do that, or a commissioner has to go to work. It's unfair.
Right. Right.
Okay? Yes, I am in the position to govern every day. I get that. And some people have full-time jobs. I get that, too. But my opinion is this. We need to meet at least once a week. And this is my proposal. January and February, we're going to go twice a month.
Okay.
We're going to stay the way it is. Okay? March, April, and May will be four times.
As tempo picks up, people were outside.
Exactly.
I mean, this year, January and February, nobody went anywhere. I didn't. I didn't go a lot of
Well, places. It's budget time.
Sure.
So we're going to be meeting anyway, so we can discuss other issues other than budgets. And then you have June and July will be twice a month. It's summer.
Slows down.
Things slow down.
Right.
In October, too. I'm sorry. October would be that way. September and August would be four times.
Okay, you see the tempo, Labor Day, you pick it
exactly.
up.
Exactly, you're starting to pick up. And then, of course, the holidays come around, November, December, twice a month.
Sure, slow it down.
I really feel that that's good. That gives us leeway to schedule plenty of meetings. And the reason for that is, and I'm going to be honest with you here, okay? Some of my fellow commissioners may not agree with me, but I feel that when I ask questions and somebody's in front of me, I really do feel a little rushed. I truly do. Because, you know.
Well, a number of the things I've watched on TV, you said, folks, can we slow this down a little
bit? Exactly.
Can we come back and vote? It was some of the commissions you appointed. You said, we went too fast.
Yeah, slow exactly. Yeah. I feel too rushed. There's a lot of questions I'm asking because people are asking me to make decisions that are tough.
You don't have enough information?
Well, I don't get my book till Friday.
Okay.
Saturday and Sunday, businesses are closed to do any kind of research. Right. So then I got to take all day Monday.
To get ready for a Tuesday meeting.
To get ready for a Tuesday meeting. It probably has 50 items in it.
Okay.
That's ridiculous. So what I prefer to do is to let's move the meetings out a little bit more in the busy times. Plus, we need to meet with our department heads on an annual basis.
Okay.
More than just 5 or 10 minutes. You know,
you
Fred.
Have a real sit down with them and hey, let me learn about the transfer stations. Let me learn about the airport. Let me learn about
everything. Right. You know, I think sometimes it could take up to a half hour. When I sit down with my sales manager in my pest control firm,
sure.
It's usually for 2 hours.
Oh yeah.
Okay, and I meet once a week with my company. So and it's an all day issue pretty much. But that's what I have to do to function. And I feel we can be. We can govern better.
The idea of the weekly meetings you like, and or when I say we kind of a seasonal approach. Busy times, we meet more often.
Right.
Holidays, summertime. Hey, let's slow it down.
Right.
The important thing is get the work done, right?
Yeah, and you know we're getting the work done, but
sure,
you know we are a little stressful too.
It's a tough job.
Sure it is.
Look, let me ask a couple more.
Sure.
We have tax breaks for citizens. I know you talked about it a lot during the
campaign.
Certainly. What's your thinking now?
Sure. Well, I ran on this, and I still believe that the county deserves a tax break.
Okay.
It's very difficult to lower the property tax. As everybody knows, it's 8.499. When you lower property taxes and you try to raise them again,
it's a bad thing to do.
So what I'm going to propose after the budget season is I want to give every single taxpayer in Queen Anne's County a one-time $200 tax credit.
Okay.
And then
Across the board.
And then we can analyze it each year after year. So next year, maybe.
If it can go up, it can go up. If it needs to go down, it can go down.
Or we don't get it.
Okay.
It just depends on where the county's in a good position now, I believe. But let's see what happens during the budget time.
You know the state of Maryland's in a little
that's
bit of
exactly
trouble
right.
next year.
So
right?
that's going to be my proposal is to give everyone a $200 tax credit
okay.
across the board.
Yeah.
That's my plan, and that's what I think is a good option.
There's a lot of people smiling on the
that's
other side
good.
Of
and,
the camera.
and I'm going to do everything I can to make that happen, too. I'm still working on the motion to lower in the piggyback tax from 3.20 to 3.30.
Okay.
We just hired a new economic development director. I think this guy is going to bring in a lot of businesses, but I think one of the things that's going to hold some of these businesses back, and I've already heard from him and talking to some of these, is the piggyback tax. Business owners do care about their employees.
Sure
they really do. I wouldn't move my business to Queen Anne's County right now because I know that you would have to pay the highest in the state of Maryland. There's nobody hired in Queen Anne's County.
Oh, the piggyback tax.
The piggyback tax, 3.20. There's three counties tied with us, but That's as high as you go.
So you'd like to see that eventually.
I'd like to see
down.
It come down. It will attract more businesses. Sure. It truly will. And the other option is this, as I'm bringing forth, is the homestead tax. Queen Anne's County is at 105%. I'm going to request that we lower the homestead tax to 103%.
So you're staying with your promise of looking at the tax issues and where you can lower them in a couple of different areas.
Good. And I'm hoping that passes, and I think it will. The homestead tax is important to citizens that pay mortgages here, pay taxes in this county. Right. And I'm confident I can get it down to 103%.
Okay.
But the last set raised it to 105%.
So you're staying with your campaign promise of looking at tax issues. Good for you.
Correct. Now, and then the other thing is I'm putting in a proposal to raise our rainy day fund. Actually, I'm sorry. The funny thing here is Commissioner Moran had gone into John Seaman's office, a month ago. He walks out the door. I didn't know he was there. I called John Seaman, and Jim and I were thinking the exact same thing. Jim Moran asked John Seaman about raising the percentage from a rainy day fund from 7 to 10, which puts Queen Anne's County in a better position financially and with our creditors. Well, I did the exact same thing. Didn't even know Jim was doing it.
John's going, hey, I like this.
No, but great minds think alike is where I'm going with this. So I had already drawn up the resolution or the bill as you would. I had Pat Hansen do it. But, you know, I'm not that kind of commissioner that worries about thunder. So I told Jim Moran the other day, when the time is right, after the budget, you talk to John first. So that's something I hope that Jim and I can put through and get through.
You get one more vote and you're in business.
One more bit, and it's benefit this county 100%.
Good, okay. Any more tax issues?
None right now.
Okay, good. Recently a hot topic, homeless shelter down in the Stevensville area. Where are you on that? And I know it's become a very vocal issue.
Hey, listen. There is not a bigger person that supports homeless than Robert Charles Buckey. I have been supporting homeless for 25 years since I've been in business. I will prove to anyone where I donate to numerous homeless shelters on a regular basis. Sure. My company gives 100 jackets a year to Montgomery County Housing. It's one of my winter jackets for the homeless.
Okay,
I'm not against the homeless.
Sure.
I signed a petition because I feel that that particular building, the way it's, what it's going to be, I'm against, period. I'm just against it there.
That particular spot.
Yeah, I'm not against it at the end of State Street.
You and a lot of other citizens in the Queen Anne's County, especially the area that we're talking about.
Correct. I mean, there's two elementary schools within 200 yards, or 200, two football fields. There's a walking path. It's not a question of if, it's a question of when, in my personal opinion. And people, all they have to do is Google it and research it. I get it. People deserve to have, I get that. I understand that. I will do everything I can. I volunteer at the homeless shelter and cook.
You're in favor, obviously.
I'm in favor of a homeless shelter.
You'd like a better location.
I just want to see, let me tell you, my company does a lot of homeless shelters, the pest control part. 90% of these things, 95%, are not located in this type of environment.
They're in different types.
That type of where you call the 24-hour transition, where you know they come in at night, leave.
Right.
They're not there in that type. They're usually in an industrial park.
Okay.
They're in that type of setting.
Away from residential areas.
Away from residential areas and schools. It's for obvious reasons. I'm not going to, you know, you can understand why.
Sure.
I'm not penalizing anyone. I'm not saying anyone's bad because that's not the case. But you just don't want it in a residential community.
You've joined with a lot of citizens in the Stevensville area and through other counties. You're saying, hey, look at folks, heart's with the homeless situation, but we need a better spot.
Okay, listen, you as a citizen, I'm a citizen first.
Sure.
I really am, okay? And I took a lot of heat from my fellow commissioners. I did. And it was
on this issue.
Sure, and they realized now I was not self-serving.
No.
But my fellow commissioners knew I was doing this. I was advised not to, that it wasn't a political move. I don't care about politics, Fred.
You're trying to do what was right.
Look, leadership is in your actions, not your position. So that was an action that I did to show that my as a leader of the community now, I don't support this at that location. I will support it a half a mile up the road. As a matter of fact, we have donors now in the county, willing to donate land to build
move
that shelter.
Down. Okay. So you want to see a continuing discussion on
yes,
this,
sir.
And let's find a better place.
Absolutely.
And that's your stand. And that's a fair stand.
And I'm not going to fight. Look, if it stays there and the state says it's good, great, fine. I don't even talk to the state about this. This is
A local issue.
A local issue to me. I haven't talked, and I won't talk to anyone from the state about it. But that's okay. Thanks for asking me that, because people have said to me that I'm against a home. I just serve spaghetti.
Location.
Exactly. I just serve spaghetti for the Heaven Ministries.
Yes.
And I made the spaghetti homemade.
Okay. With good stuff.
Real tomatoes. It took me 48 hours. If I was against a homeless, I wouldn't have done that.
You wouldn't be doing that. That's fine. Okay.
Anyway,
all right.
Thanks for asking.
Now, another hot topic during the campaign, a YMCA project.
Oh, great.
Is that alive, dead?
Yes.
What do we got?
Yeah, it is. I really can't go into details yet, but I can tell you that, as you know, I ran against the Y with the county supporting it with money. Right. I think it's bad business, and I still do, because it competes against other business. But I support the Y, as you know.
Sure.
I have been negotiating with the YMCA since the day I took office.
You just want a better deal.
I got a better deal.
Okay.
Actually, I got my proposal is that we donate the land.
Okay. The county donate the land.
The county.
The
county paid $1.1 million for 47 acres in 2009. $1.1 million. The county is only donating 15 acres to the YMCA.
Okay.
Now there are some criteria to that. They have to build the Y within a certain period of time. They have to run the Y and maintain it for a certain period. If the Y by any chance goes belly up or they can't afford it, the county has the first right to refusal to buy the building at fair market values.
The whole facility then would be ours, basically.
Exactly. If the Y doesn't build the facility in a certain period of time, the land comes back to the county citizens.
Okay, so you're putting
charge.
A little pressure to make a timeline,
correct.
Et cetera.
Correct. We have some issues now with the timeline on where people...
You're negotiating.
We're negotiating. Myself, I believe in the organization. I think we should give the YMC as much time as they need to raise the money.
To work it out.
That's my personal opinion.
Now, we're still talking out by the county office building out by the high school.
Yes,
sir. That's still where we're talking
Absolutely.
About?
And I'm going to do everything I can to be a champion for this YMCA to come here.
Okay. Well, that cleared that up. Well, I was going to ask you kind of a fun question.
Sure.
The commissioners now have been in office about 100 days.
Right.
What's been the
Has it really?
Yes. Well, you figure you're now December, January, February. All right. We're into March. About 100
right.
days. First 100 days. What's the most fun?
Oh, the most fun that I have.
Or is it all gray hairs?
No. it's all gray hairs. The most fun I actually have is when I'm sitting up there getting ready for a county commissioner meeting.
Okay. That being the preparation and the
Correct.
Chit-chat going on before.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. No. Not the chit-chat. The actual meeting itself.
Oh, the meeting itself. Okay.
That to me is...
You really enjoy that.
I really enjoy engaging with the community, letting them know what's going on behind the scenes.
Okay.
That's why I want them to know so much more. I think that everybody deserves more. Government needs to be open. I believe in transparency government, 100% across the board. But I don't believe in transparency government when the government has to step in the way of business, though. I think that businesses should let business sector do its thing and less government in business. Well, everybody knows what happens. Business thrive.
Sure.
But I also believe that the government should be small, which we're shooting for, and it should be transparent because no one is above the law, not even me as a county commissioner. You know, it's a funny thing you talk about. They were talking about the speed cameras here in Centerville.
Right, right.
You know, I don't care. I'm glad that you guys got speed cameras. I mean, I
slows
get it.
Slows people down just, as a citizen.
You know,
I like it.
Just slow down. But I've received 2 tickets just trying to get to the Liberty Building on time for a county commissioner meeting.
Slow down, Robert.
Yeah,
down.
But that's right.
Okay. So the meetings, you really enjoy the meetings.
I really
do. Okay.
And by the way, I'm enjoying the engagement with the community.
Good.
My phone rings, literally, you can ask any other commissioner. My phone probably rings 20 to 30 times a day from normal citizens.
Okay.
People, and 95% of the people that I knocked on their door, and they remember and said, hey, you know, I'm going to call. And I knocked on 5,000 doors through the primary and the general. And these 95% of these people that I knocked on their doors just going, hey, Bucky, you're doing a great job. Keep up the good work, blah, blah, you know, that kind of stuff.
So good.
I'm really enjoying, and the emails, I'm enjoying that.
Citizen feedback,
yes.
And meetings is a good part. What was the biggest surprise? Was there one thing that just, I mean, one thing you've said to me, I don't think you were surprised by it, but you're delighted in the quality of your staff.
Oh,
your full-time staff, and all these department heads, you're just amazed how great they are.
Let me tell you something. Margie, that works upstairs for the county commissioners,
keeps you all out of trouble, doesn't she?
Is an angel.
Okay.
I don't think we could survive without her personally. Linda, same way. The people upstairs, them two individuals, are just
keeping you straight.
They're good for the county.
Good.
They're good for the county. Todd Mann. I mean, I'm not even going to talk about the man.
Nothing but pluses.
Nothing. I mean, the guy deserves. He just It's people like that are just Greg Todd. I mean, they're just hard workers for the county.
And they're serving you well and serving the public well.
Correct. Correct.
Well, it sounds like enjoying the meetings, enjoying the feedback, and the delightful type of staff we have. These are all nice plus things for you to work in for the next 3.5 years, right?
Right.
Now, you're encouraging people, and let's share some information here.
Sure.
If they have questions, not only about third district issues, but anything in the county, to contact you. I know you're big on that.
Absolutely. Anybody has a problem with anything, please contact me. I probably get, I want to say, 10 emails a day / phone calls from citizens telling me this has been broken on Route 8, or this is down, or that's down, or there's not a flagger out at the Royal Farms in Graysonville. I get on it for them right then and there. I don't hesitate.
Do you prefer email? How do you like people to contact?
I prefer emails, personally.
Can you share that with them?
Sure. It's rbuckey, B-U-C-K-E-Y. @qac.org.
And you encourage him 24 hours a day?
24/7. You know, like I said, I'm up till usually 10, 11 o'clock at night working on county stuff, researching. You know, a lot of this is research.
You've got to find the history of it. You have to get the facts.
Well, I got to have, exactly. You know, there could be a bill that comes up. And, you know, one thing that I do is I research. That's why you see me, as you notice, I don't vote on equipment.
No.
There's a reason for that. Because I go out and look at our equipment. Now, I'm not knocking anything. I'm an old school Republican. I'm so conservative that
They want a new tractor. You want to see the old tractor, see what it's made of, and what it's going to cost.
And plus, I just don't believe that it's budget time. Just because it's in the capital budget doesn't mean you need to spend the money.
Okay.
I just don't believe that. I think that's the old way of government, and you know what I'm talking about. Okay. 70s, 80s,
sure,
and
sure.
Getting into the 90s. Bill Clinton kind of changed that format of if the school board gets $100,000 a year and you only spend $90,000, so be it.
Yeah.
The school boards struggle to spend $10,000. It doesn't happen that way anymore.
No.
And I don't operate that way.
It's not waste money just because we have to spend it.
It's just because it's in the budget. That's what got our budget where it's at now. And it's going to be, we're telling you something, we commissioners have a job coming up.
Oh, this budget's going to be tough.
This budget. Yeah. It's going to be tough, and I'm going to tell you something. If it goes over 118, 119 million, these citizens are going to be upset.
Okay.
I'm telling you, I think it's bad. We need to find ways to make cuts, and we need to make precedences now that just because it's in the budget doesn't mean you spend it, period.
Robert, last question. We'll let you go. What's the one thing this first year, okay, we've talked about issues, but what's the one thing you really want? What's not like a bee in your bonnet? You know, there's one thing I really want to get done the first year.
YMCA.
The YMCA.
I want that YMCA done. I want it done within a month. I want it locked. I want it solid. The YMCA has been jerked around too long now in Queen Anne's County. The county does deserve a Y. You and I've talked about this. I believe in the Y. I just can't give $4 million of tax dollars.
You want the best deal for the citizens of Queen Anne's County.
Correct.
And I don't think any citizen's going to fuss.
And if we let this Y go, shame on us.
Okay.
That's all I'm going to say.
Okay.
Shame on us if we let this thing rock through.
Well, good. So, well, Robert, thank you for joining us.
Hey, man, I really enjoyed this.
We want to make this a regular event for you, okay?
I think I'm going to come once a week.
No, you should. We're here. The staff's running out the door, but you and I will be
here. That's right.
I'm Fred McNeil, and you've been watching QATV7. This is Commissioner's Corner. We've been with Commissioner Robert Buckey, and he's talked about a lot of topics. He wants you, like the other commissioners, contact him when you have questions.
Can I say one other thing real quick? I'm sorry.
No.
My next town hall meeting
is
intentionally set for May the 2nd.
Okay, it's not going to be 10 degrees, thank goodness.
Thank goodness. It's going to be on a Saturday.
Okay.
I'm hoping, I'm thinking I'm going to do like a noon to 2 or noon to 3 type of deal.
Sometime during the day.
Right? And it's going to be a tough one. It's going to be whether or not the county commissioners should entertain open the comp plan.
Okay, all right. So that'll be the theme of the meeting.
That'll be the theme of the meeting.
And if you had 70 on a 10-degree night, Lord knows what you're going to get on a 50 or 60-degree night.
I'm hoping I get 100, 200 people. People, this is your opportunity to come talk. This is going to be televised, by the way. Come out and tell me how you feel about it. We can all talk about this. Let's work it out. There's a lot of things going on right now in Queen Anne's County, so I want to hear from you. I'm not saying I want to open the comp plan. I'm just saying this is going to be my topic. I want to hear what the people have to say, because the comp plan, if you've been following the county commissioner meetings, have been a topic. So I want to hear from the people.
Good.
So,
okay. All right.
And not Facebook people. I want to hear from the real citizens of this county.
Maybe don't use Facebook and stand up all the time.
Exactly.
But at a meeting, okay?
Exactly.
Well, Robert, thanks again.
Thank you.
And we'd like to thank you again for watching QAC TV7. I'm Fred McNeil. My time's up. Thank you for your time, and we'll see you next time.